Hi, I'm Ron Woerner, professor in the College of Science and Technology at Bellevue University. This is my story for the Triumph of the Nerds series. When I first saw this computer, it was back about seventh grade. I had my math teacher and my biology teacher were kind of the sponsors for it. And they showed us some very simple math programs to use. I remember one where it was a math game. You would get to shoot something like an alien using the very basic graphics. And then to complete it, you would actually have to answer a simple math problem, whether it's addition, multiplication, subtraction, or division. And very simple, but it spurred my interest because I could see what was possible on the computers, where you could play the computer games, simple games like Space Invaders. On this model of the TRS-80, you had a simple black and white monitor. Came with the computer, could be almost considered the original laptop, although it weighs about 20 pounds, built-in keyboard. And what was unique with this model is that it's a fully functional keyboard, typical QWERTY keyboard. Some of the models before it had very cheap, also known as chiclet-like keyboards. This screen was completely black and white. I believe it was 96 characters across by about 40 characters, and it was all character-based, letters and numbers and blocks. There were really no graphics at the time. A computer that came out shortly after this one, affectionately known as Coco or the Color Computer, also developed by Tandy, was known for having its color graphics, but this one, strictly black and white, as was typical in the early 1980s. A problem we had with these is that if you left them on, the characters would burn onto the screen. When you turn it off, you'd still see remnants of the characters. And if you could look up close on this, you might be able to see some lines on it. In the military setting, this caused a problem, because if they worked with any sensitive or confidential data, they would have to go and destroy the screen, literally take a sledgehammer to it when they were done with that computer to make sure everything was gone. Let me tell you a little bit more about the TRS-80. It came from Tandy Corporation, sold at their Radio Shack stores. And at the time, there were over 3,000 of them across the country. So it made it easy for people to find one at their local Radio Shack store. It used a Z80 processor, and that's where the 80 in TRS-80 came from. This was the Model 3. The Model 1 came out in 1977, but it had a problem. It had too much electromagnetic radiation. So both Apple and Tandy had that problem, so they developed the next model. That's why the Apple Model 3 came out very shortly after their Model 1. The TRS Model 3 came out. And this was sold in the stores for around $600 up to $2,500. If you think about it, prices of computers have not really changed over the last 30 to 35 years. This was also one of the first computers people could get for the home, business, or school. Before that, most of the computers developed by IBM were huge mainframes. These allowed people to have computers right at their fingertips and begin learning about the computer. One of the first experiences I had with computers was more with the networking of it, trying to hook it up to early internet, if you would imagine. We would have what's called a modem hook up to the telephone. Now, this computer here didn't have the ability to do that without an additional peripheral. I remember the color computer I had, where I would have a 1200 baud modem, which was super slow. And I would use it to connect up to some of my friends' computers. And we would be able to share games in that manner. Another memory I have, again using very old and slow technology, was using cassette tapes. Cassette tapes were used for music, but we could also use it to store data. And hooking up a cassette tape to a computer such as this in order to save the programs or load programs, and it would often take maybe 5-10 minutes to load a program, so you really had to be patient with it. The programming language was BASIC, which was kind of basic for the day. I could run some very simple commands, and I would get programs out of magazines, believe it or not. Go to the store, buy a magazine such as Byte, and look for programs in there. And they would be very simple programs to do math or very simple games like Space Invaders. When I share experiences based on this, we all come from the same generation that used early computers, whether it was an early Apple computer TRS-80 or their color computer, VIC-20 or Commodore 64. We all had to learn how to program them ourselves. We would get the programs out of magazines. So when I meet my friends, we talk about those old magazines and those old computers that we would use. Amazing how much the speed has increased over the last 30 years of using computers. Today, we don't even think about it. And if it takes more than 10 seconds, we think it's a slow day. There's a lot of rich history in computers, and I suggest you go out there and explore it and become your own nerd and join the triumph of the nerds.